Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our beginning band sixth grade concert. We still have some seats over here on this side of the gym for those of you that are standing in the doorway. I encourage you to come across and have a seat if you'd like. Be more comfortable than standing there for an hour, or not an hour, about 40 minutes. Well, like I said, this is our beginning band concert, and sitting before you is our sixth grade band of flutes, clarinets, trumpets, and trombones, and they have been working very hard all year so far. I'm sure you've heard some of that in your house. My name is Mr. White. I'm one of the band directors, and my colleague, Ms. Pesch, is the other band director here in Hastings, and we're excited to show you tonight. Excited to show you all of the progress so far that we've been making. So, we kind of want to start out though with like a little bit of our life, the first few weeks of school, by demonstrating to you what the band sounds like the first day we play our very first note. So this is what it sounds like on the very first day. So we're going to take you down the road of our band book a little bit and play some songs for you. The way the concert's going to work is we're going to play a song as a whole band. We might feature a section during that performance. And then after that, we will open that up for some solos and duets that our students have signed up for. And they know the order of those. So when we finish the full band, that's an appropriate time to clap. Ms. Pesch will put her arms down. And then when we do the solos and duets, we will do all of them for each song before we do the applause. So we don't have to applaud every individual solo or duet, we'll just applaud the group at the end. And I'll let you know when that is. You'll hear it at the piano. So without further ado, we're going to begin with number 15 in our band book called Rising Rhythms.
Thank you.
Our next selection is going to feature our flutes, and it is called Stepping Stones.
Thank you.
feature the trumpets, and it is called In a Minor Mood.
Thank you.
trumpets and the trombones, and later on, before we hit Christmas break, we'll end up adding the rest of the instruments into the band also. So you'll be seeing some information in our weekly emails, as well as handouts that are going to be going home in the coming days. Speaking of weekly emails, if you are not signed up to receive those, there's a pad of paper on the table that you came in by, and you can sign up for those. This is the way that we send home information in addition to handouts. But if your student doesn't get a handout home, this is the only other way you're going to receive that information. So if you're thinking that maybe your student doesn't take home papers, that could be a discussion. But this could be a kind of a backup plan. You could ask them, hey, what did you receive in class today about such and such? And they're like, oh, yeah. So that sign up is right over there at that table. Also, I'm giving them, this is called a chop break. We're giving them a rest for a second. Also, on that table, there are half sheets of white paper that are for our annual poinsettia sale. That was put in the email this week, but if you didn't get those papers, you can pick one up on your way out. We sell poinsettias for the band program and the choir program. And the really neat thing about band is when you do individual fundraisers, they benefit your student to help them continue in band. So they all right now have an individual band account through our awesome and very supportive Band Booster parents. And for every plant that they sell, they earn $5 in their band account. We earn like 17 cents left over for the Band Boosters. We're not doing the fundraiser to raise money for the band. We're doing it so they can raise money for their band accounts. And that money can be used to purchase things like reeds, band books, things like that that come up every now and then in band class. But they can also save up that money and use it for a bigger thing, like going on a trip with the band or paying for band camp in high school. So you can start earning money for your band account even in sixth grade. So we really encourage students to do that, and that kind of opens up opportunities for them down the road. Last announcement, and then we'll play some more. Along those same lines of band accounts, we are really fortunate in Hastings that the Band Boosters operate our concession stands for all high school events. So every time there's a basketball game, wrestling match, swim meet, football's over now, but any sport, whenever there's a concession stand open, it's being run by the band parents. And this also can benefit your student, because every time you volunteer in the band, in the concession stand, you will earn $10 for your band account. So that can add up quite a bit, and that's per volunteer. So if you and your significant other sign up to volunteer, you can earn $20 for your account. Students at this age are too young to volunteer. They cannot, they can be there with you, but they wouldn't be counted as a worker. Only high school and up are counted as workers in the actual concession stand. But this is a great opportunity to, one, earn money for your band account, but also, secondly, this does also benefit the Band Boosters greatly. It's about a 50-50 split with the Band Boosters earning money and the students' accounts earning money. So we really hope that you sign up for those. Everybody can do a little bit, and then it's all taken care of. And those signups are located also on those weekly emails. There's a link. Usually it says something like, earn money for your band account. And there's a link there to click on. And that clicking will take you to the website to sign up. Okay, that's a lot of words. Sorry. We're going to continue on now by playing, I think, one of their favorites, which is Go Tell Aunt Rhoda.
Thank you.
almost that time of year. So you can, you have something for your child to play for your relatives when they're over for the holidays. Tell them to play Good King Wenceslas. Thank you. Before we play our final selection, after we're finished with tonight's concert, I have some books for sale. If you're interested, they're called Tons of Tunes, and there's like, I don't know, 15 or 20 play-along songs. They come with a play-along CD. They used to be $13. They're now only $5, but I don't have that many. So I'll be over at the table if you'd like to buy one, cash or a check made out to Hastings Middle School. I can make change, sort of, so if you'd like to buy one, we'll make it work over there. And our students know what they're responsible for, because they're going to put away their chairs and music stands at the end of the concert. You guys have been a wonderful audience. Thank you so much. We're going to play kind of our big grand finale here, which is a piece of sheet music. So everything you heard tonight was only 8 measures long with some repeats in it. And our final selection is actually, like, how many? Oh, they got 61 measures long. And it's a medley of holiday tunes, and it really features the trombones heavily. It is called Holiday for Basses. We hope you enjoy our final selection. Thanks again, and we'll see you soon. I'll be with our songbooks.